Welcome to the first game of the finals. It's quarterfinals between Muggles and Basilisk. And we have brooms up. Osman, look, Kenji slides in and Forpy's able to pick it up. He's going to run down, pass, miss. Taya was there, but she wasn't able to reach it.
Beat by Zach, Taya. Nice defense by the Muggles.
Good defense there. So who has control here? So where's the second bludger? Oh, yep, Muggles have control. And we've got Nathan Morton and Zach with the bludgers. And Dan the man's taking it down. What do you think about today's game, Dundee?
Look, there's a lot riding on it. This whoever loses this game is out of the finals.
First goal. There. Who scored that one?
Dan the man.
Dan the man.
Dan.
Yeah.
2.0.
As expected.
That's 10 for the Muggles.
So it is an elimination final.
Yep.
So whoever loses gets kicked out. Whoever wins plays the loser of
the Rackspurs and Manticores.
Yeah.
That game coming up in about an hour or so.
Oh, Bludger Control's gone back to the Basilisk. Nice tactic.
So Basilisk ended up third on the ladder, Muggles fourth. Only one game apart between them though. The Muggles took down the Manticores in one of the last few games, which was quite unexpected. Zeet's back. Zach is beat.
Oh, Tay's gonna put this one through. No, pass it back out. Well done.
Oh, good defense there. Good stop by Dan. Goes back to Forp. He's going to pass it over to Taya. Oh, good positioning, but she isn't able to put it through. But, yeah, no, they didn't call it.
Recovered by Caitlin there.
Good blocking there by Dan and Caitlin.
But that was good rebounding by the Basilisk. They managed to get a few shots on goal before the Muggles got possession.
Good passing around goals. Taya realising that she didn't have the shot on. Passing around to get a better opportunity.
The score is still 10-0 to Muggles' way. Muggles, I know Basilisk have bludger control.
Looks like Basilisk employing a man-on-man defense here. Bludger's going wild down the Basilisk end.
Dan passes to Caitlin and puts it through. It's a good play. Basilisk aren't looking as dangerous as they normally do so far, and their defense is not really holding up to them.
Caitlin was just too quick for Taya there, got in the forward position. With that ball running straight onto the goals.
So Adrian comes on as a beater. So Adrian and who's the other guy with him?
It's a girl.
That's Sin?
No, sorry, I was asking who had the quaffle as well.
Kenji. Fujihara.
Go on, Adrian, get on it!
And number 14?
Oh, God, they keep passing.
It's okay, Forp has it now. Runs around, doing circles. Oh, I'm back. Yeah. Good work, but just missed.
I'm not sure who the Basilisk keeper is. Is he new? Number 14.
Mark Dorman.
Oh, that's Mark Dorman.
Mark Dorman, yes, I see.
Yep.
Definitely not new. One of the keepers for the Victorian Leadbeaters.
All right. Bad with names and faces.
Max passes back.
Kenji putting the pressure on here, really making them earn every step.
There's a beta battle going on behind the Basilisk hoops.
Zach does well to pass for it back. Oh, and Adrian misbeats, and Zach's going to be able to recover that.
Caitlin's seeing the opportunity. She's going to wheel round.
Oh, well, good done, blocking Torby. By Thorpe, and good dive onto it. And you just run it straight back up. But Muggles do have bludger control now.
It's well done by Thorpe, essentially saving the goal in the Basilisk didn't have any kind of bludgers back.
It's quite windy here today. It's still 20-0 in the way. Oh, and Max is able to take it.
Great
just
turnover.
Some sloppy turnover.
The Basilisk were too confident that they could get it through.
I think Thorpe is running back, knew he had nobody to pass to, couldn't pick up the ball, couldn't throw back, couldn't kick it back. Elected to just get beat and try and defend the goal face, but Max was too quick for him.
Muggles are looking dangerous today. They've looked dangerous the last few games they've played. They've really come together at the end of the year.
They've been a bit more organised, more focused on tactics.
Okay. Mark face Dorman beat. Takes it in. Kenji gets beaten. Bit of a whack after beat, but still okay.
Motion.
Motion, yeah.
Couple of quick subs for Max, the Muggles.
Max is going to come off. Few swaps there. Maddie came on,
yeah,
and
trying to see the
Dan's taking
up.
It
yeah,
up.
I can't see it, so I can't.
Has a few options there. It's got two chasers behind the hoops, one on each side. It's got a shorter option as well, yeah. But is he going to try and run it in himself? Yep, no beaters now. Oh, we've
Dan's
still got,
take it down.
Got one behind, and Maddie's there. Passes it.
Ooh, nice.
Ooh,
oh, well
good
done.
Blocking
take
by Taya.
Nice.
She's all arms and legs. Connor Saunders comes on.
Basley slowing it down, but Connor really putting the pressure on the beaters.
Connor's
there.
Beating there by Muggles.
Oh.
Go!
That Muggle.
Good recovery there.
Sam Kilpatrick.
Basley's putting a goal on the board, making the score 10, Basley's 30 to the Muggles.
You'd expect it to stay in snitch range most of this game, wouldn't you? Both sides are quite aggressive.
Unfortunately, for myself.
Oh, yep, we've got snitch right here. Hopefully, he can do better than last week. That was a disgrace.
Oh, well done, Mark Dorman, showing skill there, really getting in between the two players and knocking that one down.
He's got options, but he's going to run it in himself. Oh, great
well
tackle.
Done.
Good steal by number three.
Edward.
Is that his, might be his first season.
Ed.
Yeah.
I think it is Ed's season. Oh, Fuji wheeling around, really putting the afterburners on there. Just took slightly too long.
It was looking a little bit pretty there with that jump.
It was trying to fake him out.
Yeah.
Ed was right behind him.
Still marked ball. Oh, pass through. Tay might up this one still. Still with the best list.
Just weight of numbers. Osman might be able to put this through. Tay is still there. Yeah, goal. They needed that, so it's 30-20 now.
To the Muggles.
Really good defending by the Muggles there, but just the persistence of the Basilis to put that one through.
Need to work on their rebounds. Basilis have too many shots on goal.
Yeah.
Like, because there was a sea of Muggles and they still got it in. Ooh, Connor drops a bludger.
Fantastic. Speed there. Oh, Maddie,
good
behind
passing.
Goals.
Oh,
great pass, but didn't work. Basilis going to go for it again. They've got Osman down deep. Mark Dorman. But Muggles still have bludger control.
I haven't seen much of...
Kenji's going to run it in, but nice challenge there. Good pass back. Ooh, bit of a behind tackle by Connor on there, but no one called it.
Dorman, and he's got a three.
Okay, so we have brooms up. There was no card given, so that goal does count, and it's 30 all.
Basilis really coming back, three solid goals in a row here. Nathan Morton making the field, playing a spectacular game last week. Looking to
Dan just takes it all in by himself.
Connor taking back the bludge control.
Yeah.
Good work there by Connor.
That was all bludger play there. Nathan Morton just coming in, taking out the bludger straight away so that Dan could push it through.
Yeah, it was a good goal, but they did lose bludger control because of it.
Worth it, maybe?
Yeah.
Does put them back in the lead.
It does. 40-30, Muggles way.
And they do have two very strong beaters on the pitch. Nathan Morton pushing up with a bludger. No support though, no other chasers around him.
There's been about 10 minutes played in this game so far, so it's going to be a reasonably low scoring game. Oh, good passing there.
Got Lynn with the ball.
Good pick up by Lynn.
Didn't see that bludger.
Should have gone for the pass. Dorman was open.
can be hard to get a pass off when it runs around.
Yeah, I just don't think she had the vision when she stood up. She didn't see that beater close. Short, thought she had the advantage.
Few new players coming on for the Muggles. Dan's going to pass right back to him, and dismounted.
And gives the ball back to the Basilisks. Basilisks both with budget control and quaffle. Mark Dorman bringing it up the pitch.
Can be slippery, the PVC, sometimes.
Brooms down. All right, no call, just a warning. I'm not sure what the warning was actually
Someone's
for.
Someone's doing something after being beat, I believe.
Edson back to hoops. Just a warning, and play recommences with Thorpe taking it down the right-hand flank.
Graham Dunn, Cassie Grace, blodge control back for the Basilisks.
This is an interesting combination.
Thorpe pushing through. He's going to take his pink. Oh, deep.
Bit of an alley-oop. I like that.
That should be... Oh, that was a bit contentious.
And this is only second game for Graham Dunn playing under Basilisk colours. He's a very tactical beater.
Just an interesting call there. Apparently kicking back cannot be called an illegal reset.
But apparently kicking can't, is what Liam said.
Kicking can't.
Only a pass back counts as illegal reset.
That's what I said.
Interesting. So did that goal count?
Osman was beat before he hit the end.
Slips up, loses quaffle control.
Let's push it up.
Defended.
Graham, get back in the dam.
Thorpe's going to take it up.
But he's going to be beat.
Dan's easily got that covered. Oh! That was a bit of a silly pass. He should have just held on to that then.
It's okay. He's turtling it over there.
Yeah.
Could have been costly for the Muggles there.
Quite unnecessary.
You've got to be really careful if you're only just passing back to your own keeper.
Pressure of the finals, maybe?
Yeah, possibly.
Let's all be reminded of the time where it wasn't a goal quite a few games ago and someone passed it back to the keeper through the hoop and it counted as a goal for the other team. I can't remember what teams, but it was very funny.
Can't remember
so don't
that.
Do that.
We'll have to have a look at the replays.
That was a couple of months ago.
Okay.
It was great.
Probably me.
One of the Muggles floating behind hoops.
Muggles trying to push up.
Max is goal. Good knockdown. So, good beat there by Graham. Thorpe's a bit of a push in the back.
It's too quick.
That's okay, I believe. But it was a bit of a push in the back.
Justine just having a few words to him there.
Yeah. May have just been a warning. I don't think it's cardable, that.
Yeah.
If I do it, but I'm pretty dodgy with that, so they know to look out for that.
I've got a
brimstone call.
No, you're fine. Okay, so that was a yellow card to Andrew Kuhn from the Muggles. Contact from behind. So he's off for a minute.
Off to the side.
Good beating there by Graham to get rid of Morden. And that was close. May have bounced in it while it was on the ground, but didn't actually pass through. Okay, we're calling that a goal. Be interesting to watch the replay. The hoop did come off, but did the quaffle go through it? That's all that matters.
Did it start moving before the person threw the ball?
So a side note here, we've got James Osman off to the side here with a significant gash in his arm.
Significant.
Don't know if he'll be coming back on for this game.
Having to get two band-aids must be bad.
We really should get prettier band-aids, I think. Disney Princess ones. Oh, whatever.
Zach putting a lot of pressure on. Graham Dunn just dodging that beat by Zach.
So it's 40 all. Oh, Lil Luke, he passes back.
Some good passes. Ooh. Oh, Luke just wasn't ready for that return pass again.
Very fast. But they're still trying. No, I can't see it. No, the Basilisks have it.
Current score 40 all. Very tight game. Yet to see Dan take a bag in this game. Waiting for that to come out.
So Graham has the only bludger for Basilisk. He's taking it up far, but misses the beat on Zach. Oh, good beating there.
Here we go. Here's Dan.
Here we go. And there's no beaters back. Too easy.
There he does. He does what Dan does. Just pops it through the big hoop.
Yeah. The Basilis made a play for that. The beaters did go up quite hard and went for the beat on Zach. Unfortunately, it missed beat. Yeah, and just left them wide open.
That was Graham Dunn going a bit too far up, missing that beat, and then missing the tackle on Zach.
He's coming off in disgust.
Just allowed Zach to get past him behind, get that beat on. Basilis not aware of that.
Passes back to Thorpe. We've got Kenji Fujihara there. Ooh, I reckon that was through.
It was.
Yeah, that was a goal.
Brilliant. Thorpe just taking the hoops out with every one of his goals at the moment.
So it's 50-all again. Goal for goal right here. Ooh. Here we go.
Thorpe. Going to pop it in. Oh. Straight into Dan's hands.
That's going. He's trying for everything now. He does have miracle hands, but he should have gone for a pass there.
Maybe Thorpe has too much faith in his abilities. Definitely one of the best long shots in the competition, but that one was probably never going to get there.
About 16 minutes of gameplay. So Snitch comes on at 24, is that the deal?
Snitch on at 24, Seekers on at 25.
No beaters
for the Muggles. Oh, well done by Thorpe, really taking that ball down. He's got it, he's turtling.
Turtle.
Dan not letting it go though, he's really getting in there. Really trying to steal, there's no beaters to be seen.
That's the best place to turtle.
There we go.
Even with no beaters, the Muggles break through.
That was a significant play by James Thorpe, able to knock that ball out of Dan's hands.
Dan was not happy about that.
No, it wouldn't be. He's only got, one or two goals?
Poor effort for him.
It really is. He should expect more of himself. Especially now that he's on the Victorian team.
Oh, well, double beat. But Basilis do have control. Oh, Dan.
That's what strong we come to expect. Able to just pick that one out of the air before Kenji could get his hands to it. Just slowing it up now, the Muggles. Just moving forward.
Slowly. He's not as big as Truck as Mailing, but he really is a force. He's a brick wall. The brick wall in front of
Given that he's had a lot less experience than Callum Mailing, he's doing quite well. Give him a couple of years and may have a new Truck on the field.
Again. Now they're slowly moving up fifth.
Thorpe calling the play. Ozzy back on the field. No. One more. Mark Dorman back on the field.
So Kenji Fujihara passes it off. We are missing. There are two other Fujiharas that are missing today, though. They would make a difference. They've all got legs on them. Most players have legs on them, but they're particularly fast legs, I'd say.
You're a smart man, Charlie Cutfield.
Yeah, well, we're an open sport. If you don't have legs, you can still play, but... Yeah, exactly. Oh, Thorpe. Can he run it in?
He's still got the
good
ball.
Pick up. And Fujihara's there.
He's going to go to Kenji. No.
Yeah, he does.
Kenji's going to put it through. Oh, Kenji.
Oh, high tackle. That was around the neck.
They're going to call advance. They have to wait.
His hand isn't up.
One of the assistant refs had their hand up.
No, they're not calling anything there.
What the hell?
They're saying he ducked into it, I believe.
I'm not too sure about that. Yeah. It looked like he was taking his head off.
Yeah, I don't think
it wasn't
so.
Big duck.
I think the tackle...
It was going to be high, him. Whatever he did, I believe. But anyway.
I think the first tackle... Ozzy's really put some pressure on here. Just with that Kenji tackle, I think the first tackle really affected him, made him lean into the second tackle, and that's where the high came in.
Yeah.
It definitely was not Kenji ducking into it.
I think it was a cardboard offence, but anyway.
Oh no, Mark Dorman not seeing that Osman had been beat there, throwing it straight to the Muggles.
So I just don't understand the previous yellow card for the touch behind. I just don't see, like, for a high tackle like that, I think that's, you know, more dangerous. They should be cardable, but
do understand,
not an expert in the rule book though, by any means.
I do understand the leaning into it, that, you know, players can get unfair advantages by leaning into a fair tackle, but that one was dangerous.
Oh,
that's flicked on.
He really had, he had enough time there, he just took it a little bit too much. Should have gone for that. Now, Muggles regain blood control. Bit of a, is that tackle over the shoulder?
No, I think he made contact with the ball first.
Made contact down low.
That's not it. That's not it.
Oh, it has to be above the neck. Yeah, okay. So Dean just confirming that tackle was fine. It was just over the shoulders, okay. It just can't be above the neck.
Oh, big beat, big miss beat. Oh, but it worked. Worked to their advantage, and that's another goal for the Muggles.
So that's 60-50, and there's no bludgers back.
Ozzy with the ball, he's going to push it through. He's going to use his strength.
He needs to get there. There's the bludger coming.
Oh, he's missed.
He's still in. Oh!
Oh no.
Not everyone can score from the ground.
Dorman with the ball. Oh, no. Just beat Kenji.
Oh, Kenji. Oh, why?
There
yes.
he goes, and it's through.
Finally.
So many shots. Really good passing there.
So that's back to 60-all.
Basilis with the second and the third and the fourth shot.
And
really
past 20-minute mark, so the snitch be getting warmed up.
One of the Muggles is down with something wrong with her ankle. Hope she's okay. Getting an ice pack from the first day.
Yep, just confirming that injury. Do you know who it is, Nat?
I don't know anyone's name, so no.
Joey.
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 So we're remounting there. Did Osman get a card there?
Yeah,
Osman
got a card.
Yep. Didn't see what it was for, but anyway, so score's still 60-all. Good beating there. Basilis should be able to recover this. Good pass back, but no one's there. Kenji's able to recover. Muggles still have bludger control. We're about 2 minutes away from snitch on pitch. Kenji runs it down his beat though. Good beating there. Adrian loses that. And there's no bludgers back. He has to run it in. You got Max there. Oh, goal! 70-60. In those situations, you kind of almost want to put your hand through that hoop. But it was a good shot. Minute mark and score is 70-60 Muggles way. Osman takes it in. It's not beat, miss beat. He should be able to put it through. He does. 70-all.
Column at 24.
23.
Did you get that goal?
No.
Basilis.
I put it on.
Yeah, by Osman, 70-all. Osmond. So I've got Morton and Zach trying to regain bludger control. Good pass to Luke. Puts it over. No, good recovery. Now Osmond can take it in. Easy goal.
And Basilis have bludger control again as well.
And that's 80-70.
To the Basilis.
Muggle Seeker.
And Dundee, the snitch, is released.
Look at him go.
Hoping to beat his personal best of 23 seconds,
yeah,
I think.
I believe.
looks like Max will be seeking for Muggles and Kenji for the Basilisk. Kind of expecting Osman to go straight on, but they're keeping him on pitch for chasing. Just a miss there.
Morton's doing some damage up there as a beater.
You have 20 seconds.
So it's only 10 points in it, so they're both going to go for the catch, you'd think, go for the win.
At least you will get a blue card.
You tell him, Dean.
Dean laying down the law there.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Seekers are released.
Now Seekers are on pitch. Wow, they both have some speed to them. Dundee is less hungover than last week though, so should be able to, you know, at least make the 5 minute mark. Hopefully not the hour mark. Because I've already stopped thinking of unclever things to say, but anyway, that was... should focus on the Coffle because Dan's taking it down, but good block there by... That was Dorman, yep.
Oh,
back through. Did you see who got that goal?
It was Caitlin.
Caitlin, wow.
They passed it back to her and she got it through.
So that's 80 all. Holds things up. Now Kenji's beat here. Has to go back, touch hoops on. So Max has a chance to catch the snitch and win it. Dundee pulls the cap off for some reason.
Purposeful strategy.
Oh, easy catch. How many seconds was that one?
That was a minute 7.
So that is, that was Max with the catch. Takes it through, knocks out the Basilisk. It's tough for them, but the Muggles will be happy. They will be playing next week against the loser of the Manticore's Raxperts. So final score, 110 to Muggles, 80 to Basilisk.